Clear skies. I can finally see Jupiter. Here's an awesome report titled "The Sky is in Our Grasp" by Irish Tucker, which aims to help photographers and videographers to get the best picture they can, regardless of the weather conditions outside, by providing a way to change the sky after the fact, like here, you know, taking a sunny day and replacing it with a thunderstorm, or like literally taking an alien ship from the movie District 9 and pasting that into the skies, or like adding a floating castles, you know, like here, or super moons into our videos. So there's a lot of really interesting stuff that can happen here. In this video, we'll learn about the proposed technique and try out the Google Colab notebook, which lets us actually change the sky in our own videos, as well as learn about using weights and biases artifacts for versioning the data, and then using WNV for tracking our many awesome sky augmentation experiments. I'm Ivan from Weights and Biases, and let's get started. The proposed method comes from a paper by Zheng Shazhou and talks about using a sky matting network to isolate the sky, where then the 360 degrees background images of our choice will be pasted, whether we're talking, you know, the cloudy skies images or the ones with like alien ships or floating castles, and then using optical flow to track where the pixels in the video are moving, such that our sky would then follow accordingly with the rest of the video. Now, let's try out the technique on Google Colab. This notebook utilizes weights and biases machine learning tools in some really cool ways. WNV helps you save and debug your models by tracking predictions, metadata, and versioning your, you know, models and datasets as artifacts, and then allowing you to then compare all of that info in a single dashboard. You know, we'll be using that to like try different sky augmentation techniques and then being able to compare and see like what we like, what we don't like. So to log into the WNV account, all I have to do is to click on this link here and copy the API key. If you don't have a WNV account, you can, you know, quickly create one and the process will be the same. But for me, you know, I just copy this link and paste it here and press enter, and I am logged in. I also love the way that Irish has formatted this notebook in a way that, you know, we're not actually seeing any code unless we double click on the slots and then the actual code shows up. Like in this cell, where we'll first create a new project called Sky AR in our WNB accounts and then use artifacts to download the sky matting network from the same project that the report is from. Weights and biases artifacts let you upload your files to the cloud and then automatically version them, which is really useful when keeping track of many versions of your models and datasets. In this video, we'll use artifacts to keep track of our output videos with augmented skies. As well as there's also a cool feature with artifacts where they show you the graph view that lets you map where which files came from. So it's so they're really cool, you know. So upon running the cell, we can now see the new SkyAR project appear in our WNB accounts, and you know, we can get to the project either by clicking the link here, or we can also get there by clicking the project page link here. And it'll also, you know, as I was saying, start that new run that has the artifact that we've downloaded, you know, with the sky matting network here. So in the project page, we have our runs, which are like, you know, instances of running our models or running some sort of predictions. And in the project page, we can compare them side by side, but also we can click on, you know, each run individually and then, you know, see the info for that particular run that we got. Now here we can define a few helper functions and get to the fun stuff, which is if this parameter here is set to true, we can actually upload our own videos to play with. So I have a nice video prepped here, so let's use that one. After this video has finished uploading, we get to choose our sky template, like what will be pasted as our new found sky. And as you can see, we have here like quite a few exotic choices, like the, you know, far off planets or alien ships or floating castles. Or, you know, if we actually open this drop-down menu, we have like a few more traditional choices, like a thunderstorm or, you know, cloudy skies. Let's actually try going with the cloudy skies. I've not yet tried that one. So after choosing the template, you know, we can run this cell and we're good to go. Here are some additional configurations that are, you know, that we can play with. I'll go with the defaults provided by the author of the paper here. And the next cell will pretty much start processing our video. So now we can actually begin to visualize our sky augmented videos by running this cell of code here. So now we can navigate to our project page. and see a new run appearing here. These runs are like named randomly each time we initialize, you know, a new instance, right? So this one is warm star, but you know, just a way to kind of keep track of them. So if I now click on this specific run, we can see the difference right here. And so you may kind of be asking yourself, you know, like this GIF previews are nice, you know, they pretty much lock the first 40 frames for us to kind of get a snapshot and to get the feel for whether, you know, the augmentation is working or not, you know, whether we like what we see, etc. How do we actually get the real video? So the videos here are logged, you know, they're called here as the demo.avi and the demo cat.avi files, and we're actually logging them here using, you know, just these four lines of code as artifacts. And so now if we go to our runs page with artifacts, we can see that there's like a new artifacts appearing here, and if we go to files, we can see that now here are two video files. So let's, you know, download the demo.avi file and see how it looks. So like that's actually the full, you know, augmented video here. Does a really good job with the cloudy skies, I think, you know? And the demo cat one, it's essentially like demo Avi, but it's this little split screen which lets us compare kind of side to side the before and after of changing the sky. So you can see here, you know, kind of how it, you know, used to be and how it, what it was, you know, augmented into. So now let me perform a few more runs and try out, you know, a few more of those, you know, skyline templates, and we'll talk more about the dashboard functionality and the artifacts and kind of see some more cool results. So we started off with the run featuring, you know, the cloudy skies. However, I then went ahead and I performed two more runs, and we can see them in my project. So the first run is the empty run, with, you know, which just downloaded the artifacts. Now the next runs, you know, this one with the cloudy skies. This one that I did with the District 9 alien ship, which is, you know, it looks real cool in my opinion, right? Like, who doesn't want like an alien ship floating just in the skies randomly, right? You know, that sort of thing. And also I tried the template, the sunset template here. So remember the cool thing that I was saying about artifacts? You know, we're essentially logging like to the point of how do we get the actual videos of our with the augmented skies. We're logging the demo cat and demo.avi files as the artifact with the type output video and the type video. So if I now go to the artifacts tab for the project, I can see all of the versions of our artifacts for all the three videos that we've logged. So remember, you know, the first artifact, you know, it was the cloudy skies. Then the second one that I've logged, it's the alien ship. And the third one is the sunset template sky. So the cool thing about artifacts is that, you know, even though we're logging the files that are with the same names, you know, they're all like demo.avi files, artifacts understand that the contents of the files are different and logs them as different versions of the artifact, right? And so, for instance, now if I go here and I download this demo.avi file, we can check out the actual video with the District 9 ship. Let's check it out. And there it is, floating around, just, you know, over the horizon. Yeah, I mean, it's a little bit choppy, but I think it kind of does the job for an alien ship, right? Another cool thing here is that if we go to a specific runs page and we click, for instance, here the sunset template, and we'll click on the artifacts tab here, and you know, we'll be able to see the artifacts for this specific run. And so if we now download this file, you know, we'll see the augmented sky with the sunset template, which actually looks real nice, you know, this kind of nice sunset-y sky right here. I also like the kind of color, little subtle color correction that's happening around here. It's also, you know, really brings out that sunset feel here. But yeah, it's kind of pretty cool. We're logging the files with the same names as artifacts, and we can, you know, really distinguish between them, between the different versions of those files, which is really, really cool. So I decided to do a few more tests and try this approach with a few videos that I found in my phone. So this is the result that I got. So it's a really fun technique to play with, and Aushinsky's report goes into some great detail into how like everything actually works behind the scenes, so I highly recommend that you read his report. Or you can also try it out yourself on Google Colab. Links for all of that good stuff will be in the description down below. So smash that like button if you enjoyed this video, and subscribe to our channel to see more tutorials, interviews, and talks. I hope you enjoyed this video, and thank you for watching.